How to ruin a pair of shoes 101.
What did our tour guide just say?
This is a dangerous crater because we have no idea if gases are forming to indicate a potential explosion.
Tauruses. It's the Etna mobile. So we are just now on a little hike, working our way up to the crater summit of Mount Etna.
Hey guys, let me tell you about Mount Etna. Mount Etna is one of the world's most active stratovolcanoes. It has four main craters at its summit and 300 smaller active craters. You can visit the crater via guided tour. After about an hour in an off-road bus, the hike up to the crater takes about 1 hour. When you crest the top, you're greeted by an incredible sight. The summit is at about 11,000 feet or 3,300 meters. And as you can see, it gets quite windy and cold. Locals even go skiing on its flanks in winter. There are more than 1 million people living on the flanks of Mount Etna, and so monitoring for eruption activity is really important. The volcano is a result of the African tectonic plate sinking beneath the Eurasian plate. There are more than 75 stations that are monitoring seismic activity on its flanks, but the real trick to monitoring the risk level for eruption is watching the gases. By monitoring the ratio of gases at the crater and at the lower altitudes, scientists can predict increased eruption risk. As magma gets closer to the surface, scientists detect increased carbon dioxide and helium. And then, as it gets even closer, maybe about 3 to 4 kilometers from the top, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, and water vapor predominate. Magma right below the surface sheds fluorine gas, and that tells scientists that magma is about to start flowing. Once you reach the summit crater, the plan is to walk all the way around it. Our guide first asked us, "Is there anybody with asthma?" This alerted us that the gases might be up to trouble. You can see the moment when we were walking along the rim and suddenly we're enveloped in a cloud of volcanic gases. This was actually very scary because we all felt immediate severe burning in our eyes, nose, and throat. At this point, Scylla and I basically started walk running to clear the worst of it while holding our breaths, because breathing did feel a little bit labored. The main culprit was a hydrogen sulfide gas, which smells like rotten eggs. Sulfur dioxide was probably also present and is a pulmonary irritant as well due to oxidative effects.
We just hiked through sulfur dioxide.
Gas.
Casual stroll.
Yeah, it definitely burned inside of my nostrils and my mouth.
Yeah, my eyes were burning.
Hydrogen sulfide is water soluble, and with increased exposure, it's absorbed into the circulatory system. This can lead to multi-organ injury with heavy exposure. Pulmonary injury ranges from mild irritation and wheezing all the way to acute respiratory failure and ARDS. With eye exposure, patients may develop keratoconjunctivitis. Luckily, our exposure was very brief and mild, and so we did not end up having any of these issues, although the taste in our throat and the feeling was very uncomfortable. If you do go on an Etna hike, make sure you bring a thick buff or a mask to breathe through and consider having eye protection. If you have mild asthma, I would definitely bring an inhaler. I don't recommend it if you have severe asthma or lung disease. We are standing knee deep in very hot water that's coming from this thermal pool. There's little fumaroles, which are ducts that are coming from an active volcano. We are on the island of Vulcano, and I'm very comfortable right now. And the following gases are currently bathing my body and my lungs, and I have a mild headache.
We just got kicked out of the mud baths by the Cabanieri. I hope I'm saying that correctly, but it's basically the gendarmerie, island police, and they're not letting us in, so now we're grumpily waiting in the beautiful, majestic waters that have these little gas holes and hot water coming out.
One of my favorite things is looking at the signs, then the danger signs, just to see what is being marked out, what is being staked out as a dangerous activity.
So unforeseen and unpredictable risk everywhere. Area with high emission of toxic gases. If you see dead animals, sudden yellowing or withering, gas leaks from wells or excavations, avoid standing or lying in hollows and depressions. Interesting. Wow. I can't imagine anywhere that could be a danger. What your experience is.
I'm in a natural jacuzzi right now. Complete with bubbles and all.
And rotten egg flavor.
And the scent of Satan.
The scent of Satan, eau de Satan. Gaseous emissions. Breathe in deep. I know it's warm and pleasant. Yes, well.